G'day ZiggyD here, and in this video I'll guide you through the first steps in tackling the new Endgame Atlas in the Conquerors expansion. This video will require some minor story spoilers. The new Endgame is wildly different from the old Atlas, both in the big picture of how you progress and the strategies you'll employ to get the most out of it. While it may feel very confusing now, it's actually proving to be rather easy to engage with once you learn the core mechanics and how to progress. This guide will get you started and get you your first 4 Watchstones, which will actually allow you to unlock all the way up to map tier 16. When you defeat Katava, your first step is to talk to the new NPC Karak in town. He'll request your help in tracking down Zana. First, go meet him in the old Templar laboratory where we begun mapping in previous expansions. After you've spoken with Karak, go back to the Epilogue Oriath and head to the southeast to the Fallen Courts to locate Dominus's key. Take this key and head back to town to go to the Haunted Reliquary, where you'll proceed through a series of traps to discover a map device and give Karak the info he needs to build you a map device in your hideout. From here, head to your hideout and talk to Karak to begin the mapping endgame. This sequence of events here is what kicks off the new endgame storyline and is necessary to progress further. To begin with, things start off simple enough. Just run maps you haven't completed yet to unlock and complete them by killing the map bosses. Run all of your tier 1s and then start running tier 2s and tier 3s as you get them to kill their bosses and get their map completion. Your goal is simply to complete as many uncompleted maps as possible here at the beginning on tiers 1, 2, and 3. As you continue running maps, sometime around tier 3, Zana will contact you and call you an idiot for breaking into the Atlas. Shrug this off, because this is the next checkpoint in your Atlas quest progression, and it's necessary to go through this. You'll now have both Zana and Karak in your hideout. From now on, as you continue completing maps, you'll notice that sometimes when you kill a boss, a Zana portal will appear nearby. Keep an eye out for this. Going into this portal unlocks one of the citadels on the Atlas screen. These citadels are where you'll socket the watchstones we'll get later to upgrade your Atlas. For now, don't worry too much about these, but you'll eventually unlock one for each region on the Atlas. It'll happen fairly naturally as you complete maps in each of those regions, so keep running and completing new maps. From now on is where you'll need to start paying a bit more attention though to get the real progression happening on your Atlas. Our goal is now to locate the 4 Conquerors for the first time, fight them, and earn our first Watchstones. To locate the first 4 Conqueror fights, we must head to the outer regions of the Atlas. If you've been running and completing your tier 1 through 3 maps, then you should already have some maps from these 4 corner outer regions, Haywalk Hamlet, New Vestia, Lyra Arthane, and Lex Ajoris. Right now, there's no super easy way of finding maps from each region in the map tab. Hopefully GGG adds a way to search by Atlas region, but for now, here is a little trick. Move away from your stash. Click on your stash, and as your character walks over to it, press the G key to open the Atlas screen. This will overlay the stash on top of the Atlas screen. You can close your inventory and then go to tier 3 and 4 maps and right click each of the maps to find its location on the Atlas. Check a few maps till you find some that are in one of these 4 corner regions. Ideally, grab 3 different maps from one of the corner regions, as we'll need all 3 to locate and then fight Baran, the first Conqueror. Once you've located at least one map from a corner region, run it. Baran will appear and taunt you at some point in the map. This creates influence in that map, which typically means a bunch of extra monsters from the Conqueror, and it triggers the chase portion of your Atlas progression. Finish off your map and refer to the Atlas screen. That corner of the Atlas will now be highlighted with a color signifying that a Conqueror is currently in that region and that you are now chasing them down. You need to be taunted 3 times in total by a Conqueror in order to track them down. So the next step is to run another, different map to what you just ran in that same section of the Atlas. So if you were taunted in New Vestia, you need to run another different map in New Vestia. The second different map you run, Baran will taunt you again. After that map, you must run a third map to get taunted a third time. Again, it has to be a different map to before. You cannot run the same map 3 times to get the 3 required taunts, at least at the moment. GGG might be changing this in the future. Once you've been taunted 3 times in total across 3 maps, you can talk to Karak and he'll show you on the Atlas the location of the Conqueror's hideout. Now just talk to Zana and she'll open portals to the map that they are hiding in. Run the map, kill the boss, and a portal to the Conqueror fight will open. Now just simply kill the Conqueror. Simple enough, sure, though the fights are a little bit challenging, even at lower levels. It's a pretty quick fight though, if your damage is good enough. Once you kill the Conqueror, they'll drop your first Watchstone. Watchstones are socketed into the Citadels on the Atlas screen, and they upgrade the level of that region by one each. You can also use Sextants on the Watchstones themselves to add extra bonuses to all of the maps within that region. For now, just socket your first Watchstone into a Citadel in one of the center regions of the Atlas. They'll play a large role in later Atlas progression, but for now they can simply allow some higher tier maps to begin dropping for you while we work on the three other Conquerors. Placing the Watchstone in a center region for now will help us out with progression later, and we don't want to boost the corner regions for the moment. Now that you know the process, the next steps are to repeat that same process for each of the other three corner regions. So, locate three different maps from another corner region, and run them for three tauntings from the next Conqueror. The zone will light up after the first taunting, and then after the third taunting, you can talk to Karak and Zana to open their map and fight them. Do this same process and gather all four of your starting Watchstones, which for now, socket in the four different inner regions to upgrade them plus one region level each. If you're having trouble getting three different maps from a region, you can use the 3-for-1 map vendor recipe to help a lot. This recipe works different to in the past. If you take, say, three of the same tier 3 maps, they'll sell to a vendor for a tier 4 map within that same region. This can be incredibly helpful for obtaining missing maps in a region that you're chasing a Conqueror within. There's probably some other nuances to this vendor recipe now, but for the moment it's handy for helping out with initial Conqueror hunts in the corner regions. Once you have 4 Watchstones, you technically have the ability to socket 4 in one region and unlock all the way out to tier 16 maps. That said, there is much more to do to unlock more Watchstones and upgrade your Atlas fully, which I'll be explaining in my next guide. For now though, you've made a solid start on your Atlas and completed the first and most important steps in getting your first 4 Watchstones. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. That's it for now, I'm ZiggyD, and thanks for watching.